Match reaction, Brentford 1, Manchester United 1. Kick us off with your reaction to that game.
Utter shambles from start to finish. Thought we'd got away with it there. Thought we'd get a steal. Absolutely the Man United way. And then to be honest, and I'm going to be perfectly honest with you, to concede a goal after that was an utter disgrace. The way United played, was the performance was absolutely terrible. Absolutely terrible. A team performance, that was no team out there as far as I'm concerned. After 10, 15 minutes, Brentford just looked at United and went, what's this? And throughout the game, I kept saying, what is going on here? Time after time, Brentford were cutting through us in the first half, in the second half. Then we had the chance to steal it, and I mean steal it. That would have been the biggest steal of the season. Yes, we stole it against Liverpool at the FA Cup, but in the league, I'm telling you, that would have been the biggest steal. But everything...
You just mentioned Liverpool there, but we saw some fight in that game tonight. I didn't see fight from a lot of the players out there. They looked like they were not even interested in the match, like they didn't want to be there, some of them.
There's more fight in a woman giving birth. I'm telling you, there's more fight, right? There was nothing out there tonight, any positives in any way whatsoever. I've turned around, Jekyll and Hyde performances I've said United had all season, right? I didn't expect a great game tonight. I expected United to work hard, get upfield, get in the box and create chances. Didn't come, did not come at all. And I'm telling you, I do not understand. If anyone can understand why there was no substitutes made, Rashford and Garnacho. Yes, we know Maguire come on. That was because of an injury. You tell me why there was no changes made to that attack, because Rashford did not run back. Garnacho did not run back. They were strolling. I've just seen him at times, just looking at players running. The wing play they had was so open. I'm telling you, it was absolute shambles.
So do you think then Erik ten Hag at half-time should have made some examples out of some of the players by changing it then at half-time?
I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe what he changed. I could not believe what he changed. He brought Maguire on. Fine, there's an injury. But he didn't do what he should have done. There was no life in that team and he should have made changes. And when he started making changes, it was too late. He brought Anthony on. Fine, brought Anthony on, took Garnacho off. And then later on, he brought Rashford off, right? Brought Mount on, brought Casemiro on. I actually thought we might just get back into the game here. Mm-hmm. That's what I thought. Yeah. It didn't really happen. And then we got the goal. Mason Mount, absolute brilliant finish. But to give it away, they were all over the place, United. To give it away after a steal, it was on the cards. Another Man United victory, stolen. And then next thing you know, they give it away. But let's be honest. Let's be honest here. 4-5-0. That should have been tonight for Brentford. If they'd have been proper, right at it, then it put them chances away. Hit the bar, hit the crossbar, then hit the bar. Goal disallowed. Pathetic. It was pathetic. I didn't see anyone working with each other at all throughout the 90 minutes or the 100 minutes, whatever you call it. I don't know what's gone wrong there. I don't know whether it's the international break or anything like that. You know, Ten Hag says, yeah, great. Great to have them back after. They'll be raring to go. Raring to go? I don't know what happened at all.
Can you think of any excuses as to why we actually perform like that today? Anything to do with the international break? I'm not trying to condone that, but I'm just trying to think, is there anything that you can actually say and point to?
There's no excuses. It looked as though they'd never played together. It looked as though they'd never played football. Mm. Some of them out there, the way they were running and all that, there was no passion, no energy, no togetherness. You know, just cutting United wide open all game after 15 minutes.
I did see around about the 60-minute mark. I don't think it actually got much better. That United had 11 touches in Brentford's box. And like I said, I can't imagine it getting much better after that. But so what was the problem then throughout the game? Was it the midfield then not pushing up further enough, you know, trying to create things for Højlund, etc.? Or was it just the wide players? You know, let me know what you think out there in the chat. But
I thought the midfield today was just so wide open. Mm. There was no communication between the midfield and the forwards. Them two wingers there in that first half summed it up with the midfield. There was no communication. There was no help. The two fullbacks there, as poor as I've seen them. That it just worked right the way through. Once it started to slow down the game, United had a bit of speed, bit of momentum in the first 10, 15 minutes. But then it slowed. And soon as they slow it, and there's no one worse at slowing the game down than Marcus Rashford. He gets the ball, he doesn't go running at the defence, he turns and he passes it back or he passes it sideways. Too many sideways passes.
I've got to be honest, when I was watching the game with you, you said as soon as he got the ball, most of the time you said, watch him, he'll stop the play, he'll pass it sideways or pass it back, and he'd done that quite a lot.
Yeah, passive. Marcus Rashford was passive. They were all passive, you know.
You've got to look on the other side, though, with Garnacho. There was two or three times where he said throughout the game, especially in the first half, look at him not tracking back, not tracking his man back. And he was doing a similar thing to what we've seen from Rashford, where he's just jogging back like tiptoeing.
I'm not just picking on Rashford. Garnacho, just walking back. I mean,
we've highlighted it quite a lot with his tracking back and his work rate, but tonight, it was like it was a different person.
Look, I seen Erik ten Hag there, halfway through that first half, get hold of Bruno and start giving it him. Made no effect.
Yeah.
No effect whatsoever. Bruno didn't react. You know, I seen him there put a couple of efforts in on goal from way outside the area. Where was the movement in the box? Like you say, Man United's touches in the box, 10, 11, 12, I don't know what it was. But it was poor compared to Brentford, who are a poor side. A very, very poor side.
Is it more shocking as well that, you know, we're putting a performance like we did against Liverpool, the fight, the hunger. You know, we have an international break, which none of us wanted, but then the first game back, we see that then from the team.
You have to look at this game and you have to say to yourself, Tottenham played earlier on, Aston Villa. You had to win this game and go for it. It had to be an attacking side. We never seen an attacking side. But that's what was needed, an attacking side. People to be adventurous, people to go for it, people like to sort of rely on not on someone else, but to rely on themselves and put that work in. You didn't see it. United had to win tonight to stay in touch, right, for a chance to be in the Champions League. And I'm telling you, it's not tonight you lost that Champions League spot, right, because there's no way they're going to make them points up. No way. It's when we played Fulham. That's, in my opinion, that's when we lost it. But that is confirmation and the nail in the coffin tonight. You think that performance is going to get better as time goes on in the league? You're just looking at the FA Cup now because I've seen it time and time again. We ain't getting in that Champions League and them players know it and they put in that performance and they're not going to do it later on. I think maybe Tottenham and Aston Villa winning might have kicked the wind out of some of them players and gone, well, that's it.
But that shows you the mentality of what we've got with these players who are still in this squad, because surely them results today would have given motivation. The professional footballers, you know, surely they don't just need the manager and the coaching staff to give them the motivation on every match day. The professionals, they should be able to get themselves worked up for the game, surely.
Listen, totally agree with you, and I think everyone else out there agree with you, but some of these players out there and the attitude in that club will throw that manager under the bus. They didn't care. They didn't communicate together. I don't know what the thoughts of the manager was before the game, what he was telling them to do, but whatever he told them, they did not do. They never pulled the socks up. They never worked hard. They never run. The energy was not there. The fight wasn't there. The commitment. You name it, the lot. Okay? It was absolutely, in my opinion, an utter disgrace. We could have stole it, but to concede that goal, it was a shambles. United was all over the place. But I'm not... Look, reality is, right, we should have got beat massively there today. That's the reality. But also the reality of Man United, the way they play football, the way they approach it, you might have a good half, you might have a bad second half or the other way round, right? But the reality is this team is Jekyll and Hyde. It is Jekyll and Hyde. And today, it was one of the worst. It was embarrassing and it was a shambles.
It did look a strong bench, one of the strongest we've probably seen all season, but you've also then got to look at it with Martinez, Casemiro coming back from injuries. Casemiro had a bit of a niggle as well, but you expected him on, like you say, earlier than what you brought him on, because we might have seen a different game for the last half an hour. We'll never know now, but...
We had to go for it.
He had to change something up tactically, because tactically in that midfield area, Brentford only had to play out, one ball out of the defence into the midfield, and they were springing attacks all the way through the game.
The midfield was poor today. Kobbie Mainoo didn't have a good game.
I thought Mainoo was okay. He was calm on the ball.
He was okay. He didn't have a good game. You expect players to perform. He didn't perform to the high standard, and that's because the players around him let him down, right? McTominay there, I thought, was poor today. I thought they were virtually all poor. I could not give any player out there more than a 4 today, and that is poor.
I'd give Onana at least a 6 or 7. I thought he won us the game with some of the saves that he actually made today. It could have been 3 or 4 for Brentford.
He made some great saves, and you can't take it away from him. So yeah. I was just more thinking of the outfield players. But when you look at Onana's performance, some excellent saves there today. And he's the only one what gets any credit off me. You know, maybe one or two people out there will be saying, oh, Harry Maguire played well when he come on. Harry Maguire, I looked at him sometimes in that penalty box, and he was just grabbing older people, putting his arms around them and, like, trying to push them all over. To me, he just looked desperate at times. He was a centre-half. He was in there, and it was carnage. And he didn't improve it. He didn't improve it.
Yeah, another game where, you had flashbacks for large parts of the first season with Hoyland looking isolated again. But do you think he could have done more himself when he did get the ball in his hold-up play? Or do you think a lot of players around him just let him down today in not giving him the service?
I don't think they give each other the service. I just don't think they were up for the fight. Listen, after 15 minutes, I don't think they were up for the fight, no matter what the manager said to him. And like I say, he remonstrated with him halfway through that first half. It didn't have any effect. And obviously, at half-time, you expect a rollicking and you expect changes. Didn't have any effect. Nothing is affecting these players. Some of these players have got no shame. Do you know what I mean? Honest to God, everyone out there what watches this regular knows I go on about Marcus Rashford, and I've never really given him praise for the last 2 years because I've never trusted him. That man, again today, had no shame, walking back, strolling round that pitch, and he wasn't the only one tonight. Let me tell you, he was not the only one. United ain't going to achieve anything. You're going to see more of that. You're going to see
The more it draws is close to the end of the season. You know, a lot of these players as well are going to be thinking about on the beach, and especially the Euros.
That's
as well.
Correct.
So a lot of them are just going to be thinking, I don't want to get injured now. Like you said earlier on, I think a lot of them in that team mentally know they're not going to make the Champions League places. So in the league, what is it really playing for? Let's just go through the motions. And that performance tonight looked exactly like that.
We've got nothing to fight for in the Premier League. Yeah. Nothing to fight for at all, okay? Because whatever happens, if we end up 7th, 8th, something like that, right? That's an embarrassment. Well, some of these players are going, okay?
Listen, some of these players, like for Manchester United and the standards, what we've been used to with years gone by, finishing for the Europa League's an embarrassment. That is not where we want to be as well.
But some of these players don't want to be there. Some of these players won't be there. Some of these players are going to get a shock because they're going to get moved on. Yeah. And some of these players are going to the Euros and they won't tackle, they won't run, they won't want to get injured or anything like that. So what are you going to see? You're going to see more passive football. That's what you're going to see. And we've got Liverpool and we've got Arsenal coming to Old Trafford. And the crowd will be up, but will it raise these players? I very much doubt it. They will not want to get injured going into the summer.
Yeah, especially if we do get further as well in the actual FA Cup as well. Players will be looking at that fixture in the final as well.
I don't think they'll care.
But then again,
honest to God, honest to God.
On a performance like that last night, if they turn up against Coventry with a performance like that, they'll give us a game and we could get beat.
I always look at time gone by in football. FA Cup games coming up, a semi-final or a final, and you think, right, I've got to fight for my place, I've got to do this, I've got to do that. These players ain't got the fight. You've seen tonight, you've seen all season. And I've said it again, Jekyll and Hyde performances, you never know what you're getting. They haven't got it, okay? And that's down to a number of things. And to be honest with you, I can't put my finger on them all, and I don't think anyone there can. What everyone's seen out there tonight, right, was a shambles, a poor, poor performance, and people who did not want to commit in a tackle or to running, and they didn't want to exert any energy. There was no clue on what the plan was tonight out on that pitch. Brentford, after 15 minutes, took it to United and should have smashed them with the opportunities they had. And United players should hang their heads in shame. And the only people what come out with credit besides Onana is the fans there, what stuck behind them and sang right through the game. They tried to G them up in that second half. You could hear them. You could hear United fans try to G them up. They're not daft. They know what they were seeing. And they were just hoping to get something. And the only hope you got was when he put that 9 minutes up.
Yeah.
That's the only hope. That was the only time I thought, do you know what? We could nick it here. It wouldn't surprise me.
Yeah, because we've done it a few times this season, haven't we?
That was the only time throughout the game I had optimism.
Yeah, a lot of people questioning Erik ten Hag. I've got to be honest in the chat that he looks baffled, doesn't really know what he's doing tactically. I'm not too sure if you have that same opinion on this game alone in an isolated game.
I think everyone's at fault.
Yeah.
I think everyone's at fault. You can blame Erik ten Hag for tactics, not bringing people off. I've done that. I've done it here tonight. And we're right about it, bringing on substitutes when he shouldn't have done. He should have brought them on earlier. You can blame Erik ten Hag all you want, but let's get something straight here. Whatever tactics were set up there, them players did not put the effort in. Whatever was going on that pitch, they did not run, they didn't tackle, they didn't speak to each other. So whatever tactics, there had to be a tactic going on that pitch. Yeah. We had three forwards, we had the midfield players. It was virtually the same team as what played Liverpool, okay? So don't be blaming Erik ten Hag fully on this, okay?
Why can they show that effort and fight against Liverpool, but then tonight,
that's
returning
right
after that?
So let's be clear on it. Yes, we're all disappointed, we're all angry, we know that. Throwing blame here, there and everywhere. It was a shambles, it was a disgrace. Erik ten Hag's got to take some of the blame. But do not blame Erik ten Hag fully on this one tonight, okay? He is to blame, the players are to blame, the tactics were put out there and them players couldn't care less. That's it.
Yeah, our Manchester Super Chat mate said unbelievable performance. I'm not too sure if it's unbelievable.
It gets unbelievable.
Because of the amount of times that we've seen it this season, to be honest with you, so it's no surprise to me. But Squire7 says, have a Horlicks on me, Tony, and enjoy the rest of your weekend, mate. Will you get to sleep tonight?
I don't think anyone watching that, right, and who's got United there, will get to sleep till early hours of the morning. There is no chance of me sleeping at all because I'm wound up, right, at the amount of effort and the desire them players shown. This is Manchester United, and it is, and I say it again, an utter disgrace.
Yeah, I might have to find you some night nurse to try and get your head down tonight. But
I might have to walk home.
Yeah.
I might have to walk home. Yeah. Get some proper fresh air.
Clear your head. But I'd just like to thank everyone for joining us for the match reaction. Not the performance and the result we wanted, but we'll be back on Monday with another video. So try and enjoy the rest of your weekend and we'll